There you go.
Thank you.
we have some leftover snacks, lemonade, you got tea and coffee, please go drink your snack. There's even keto and gluten-free. And open.
Thank you. Thank you. So I'm Michael, and so today I'm going to introduce just briefly Matthew Compton, folks. Young man here. You can read in the pamphlet that we gave about him. All I can tell you is he is phenomenal. Any other words? I mean, and Bellbringer needs a rudder, needs something to follow, and he doesn't. He brings these folks all prepared this music ahead of time. I'm off script now. I shouldn't do that. All these people came together, had learned this music, and he brings them together. He takes that ship through the channels, make sure it doesn't run into the rocks. Occasionally we've got a little rocky, but it brings us back up. And it takes a person that has these incredible abilities, because they're not going to pay attention to me, but wait till he gets up. He's absolutely amazing, and he's so young. So honored to be here today. Let me finish this discussion. I did want to thank everyone for the new folks. This is my first time to help organize an event, and people have been so supportive. These guys have been so wonderful and giving me positive feedback. And they've only beat me with the stick a couple times. Just a couple of times. But other than that, I ask that you please silence your cell phones, BB watches, and other electronic devices. Okay? That you promise to yourself? Yes. So without further ado, folks, let's just knock your socks off. What do you say?
Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. My name is Evan Compliment. As Karen said, it is my absolute honor to work with these incredible ringers the past 2 days. They, as Karen said, prepare all this music in advance for months and hours every day, for months, all on their own. And we come together to put it together in basically 24 hours, and it's amazing to see the progress from the first hour to now. The preparation already came so strong, so my job is relatively easy to just kind of be together with this. But this group is just so musical and so wonderful to work with, so I hope you enjoy your concert this afternoon. The first piece you heard was Jason Krug's Gaudete, which just translates to "Let Us Rejoice." And I think that piece exemplifies that from beginning to end. It's just joyful and happy, and I think it's with so many different rhythmic and exciting ideas that just they kind of put a smile on the face. The next piece we're going to play is "La Cloche" by John Bankey, who is now a native Floridian. I went to school at Concordia University, Wisconsin, where he was a professor at for 34 years, and then he moved here. But I had the pleasure to work with him for a couple of years at Concordia, and this is one of those pieces that just stuck with me working with him. It's gorgeous, and it exemplifies what is the bells, the translation. And so you hear this almost impressionistic style of heat, where it flows gently at the beginning, but later you get the full cathedral effect. Dr. Bankey is an organist, so in the middle section, you can hear this one, the middle part is one hand, the upper melody is another, and then you hear the pedal line and the bass. So this is a gorgeous piece by John Bankey, La Cloche.
Thank you.
The next piece we are going to play is an arrangement of the Huron Carol, "'Twas in the Moon of Wintertime," which is about what we all want right now. I'm from the Washington area, and it's a little bit cooler in general. So coming up here, it's a little bit warm. I've opened my sleeve. Sandy Ethan is one of those composers that truly can do no wrong with her writing. This arrangement exemplifies that. She takes what is a really simple melody, and it's really short, but she extends it through about three or four different incredible variations, where you get the ethereal moon, or is it, you imagine like walking in a field, and you see stars twinkling in the distance, and then you feel just the anticipation of Christmas season. This is just terrible. And it's one of those arrangements that then later moves to excitement, and then it features the rhythmic percussion section in the middle, and it's just a phenomenal arrangement. So we are pleased to be joined by Garrett on percussion. So I hope you enjoy "'Twas in the Moon of Wintertime."
afternoon. So many of the ringers you see here, all the ringers you see here, come from a whole bunch of different belt groups in the area, surrounding area. We, in Sarasota, are fortunate to have 11, right? 11 of our group here, which is, I think, a record. We have a piece that we played in our season, this past season, which was our 12th season, arranged by our own principal conductor, Greg Holdsworth. And it's a piece from Les Miserables, a beautiful piece called Bring You Home. It is in publication now with Hope Publishing, so if you love it, you can buy it pretty soon, probably by the end of the year, from Hope Publishing. Again, this is Bring Him Home by Ring Sarasota and Friends.
Thank you.
And it was one of those instruments that you can do anything on the instrument. I arranged movie scores, arranged like the Zelda, other video game scores. And so it's one of those where the instrument is so multifaceted. Alex Gieber likes to attribute it to one of the animators, I think his name's Brad Bird, of The Incredibles, where people ask this director, oh, what is it like working in the genre of animation? And he goes, animation is not a genre, it's a medium. And animation can be a Western, it can be a film noir, it can be a superhero movie. And so I think Kendall's in many ways similar to that one, like you just heard, it could be Broadway, or a lot of what this report is, it's a lot of original music. And so I think it's cool that we can experience some different types of music on the medium. The next piece I want to play is another Florida composer's, Karen Buckwalter's Outburst. Now, when we first got this piece, the term outburst didn't seem to match the piece. It sounds very dark and brooding, but I'm just going to read to you the dedication because it's kind of funny with the juxtaposition to it. So, it says, commissioned by the Raleigh Raiders in memory of Dixie Peterson, a fun, loving southern mama, grandma, and supporter of the Raleigh Raiders, whose infectious laugh and exuberant personality brought joy to those around her. And with the piece, we have to do a little bit of searching of how does this piece relate to that, and as you listen to it, the piece is more meant to be almost mischievous and kind of playful more than anything. So it has these moments of outbursts almost like a laugh where you just hear the sudden out of nowhere and you get a music box effect in the piece. And so this is Karen Buckwalter's Outburst.
Thank you.
Now to get something to read for a little bit, the next piece, Spires, was inspired by my love of nature. It starts out feeling almost like it's in a void, and you hear the strike of the note, and then almost like an echo of that note. It's like you're in a canyon, and you hit, you clap, and you hear the reverberation down the canyon. This piece uses this idea a lot through it, and it starts with what feels like a formless, almost not unsettling, but uneven sense of time. And then as the piece goes along, you get what is essentially expansion and creation of nature. There's parts of the piece where you can feel like there are continents clashing into each other, and the mountains rising from this. And then through this cacophony and chaos, you get these moments of serenity that just kind of pop out of it. And it's a moment of just rest. And then in this last, near the end of the piece, you get a moment of almost just true simplicity, where the rhythms are simple. It's almost like you're walking through this newly expanded nature in these forests, whatever it might be. So I hope as you listen, you kind of get a chance to just reflect on the moment of surrendering in yourself and where we are in the world right now. I think that's what we more than anything, moments of peace. We find ourselves in so much conflict with each other, with political figures, and whatever it is, with ourselves. Sometimes we tend to forget that we need to take moments for ourselves. So I hope you're able to reflect on something that is in your life that you've been almost friendly with. And this is inspired. surface level, but also on an emotional level. We are connected to people buying music, our favorite song, moments like this where we come together. And it's so cool to just have these wonderful connections. And so I want to thank all of you who have given me this wonderful opportunity to come with you this weekend. It has been an absolute pleasure. Thank you for your time and dedication up to the event and to now. I want to thank the organizers of the event for having me and for putting this together. These events take a lot to put together. So thank you to Karen and all the other area for members and everyone who had a part of this. Thank you to all of you for being an audience member. Great, so needs to play to the wall, so maybe filling the wall. I mean, quite simply, we're still playing to the wall, but then there's more on the side. Thank you. But it's a joy to be able to perform for people. And so having an audience here is just, it's a joy for us. Thank you, thank you. We have one last piece for you this afternoon, and it's called Majesty. Speaking of connections to people, I had the pleasure of meeting Daniel Sarin, who was the composer of this, back in 2017 when he was, I think, a freshman in high school, when he composed this piece. And so I had the pleasure of seeing the premiere of it and being a part of it. And he is an incredible composer who based originally in Southern California, goes to school in Michigan right now, but he's just an incredible composer and everything. This piece is just fun. It's fast, it's majestic, as the piece says, and it's a blast. So thank you all so much for joining us this afternoon. If you have any questions, please feel free to come talk to us. We love talking about what we do, so please, if you have any questions, and we'd love to see you at the next event. Thank you so much for joining us, and this is Majesty. you at the next event. Oh, hold on one second. Karen has some things.
Is this where I ask for money? Where's Lynn? Is this where I ask for money? I'm not this. I'm Karen. I'm the Florida State Chairman, and I have no sense of shame. So I'm going to ask you for money. No, it costs to run these events. And I'm just saying, if you'd like to donate a dollar here or there, it would be lovely to help offset some of the cost of, you know, some of this stuff. And it keeps our ringers off the street. They can afford to come here. A couple thank yous more. Michael, where are you?
Right here.
Ah. Closing bell. So, Michael, if you